Climate engineering, geoengineering, solar radiation management programs are an absolutely undeniable reality. The ongoing illegal climate intervention operations are decimating the biosphere. This includes further fueling catastrophic forest fires all over the globe. Those who ignore or deny what they can see with their own eyes, the profoundly altered aerosol sprayed skies, grid pattern skies on some days, with nothing on other days, are turning two blind eyes to the immense and ongoing climate engineering threat. Jet aircraft spray dispersions are often seen being turned on and off, which countless film captures prove is occurring in skies all over the world. We're not seeing condensation trails. Jet engines are not being turned on and off. We're seeing intentionally sprayed aerosol dispersions that are a primary aspect of geoengineering and solar radiation management. If jet aircraft are being used, in fact, for geoengineering and solar radiation management aerosol spraying operations, they must have nozzles, and indeed, they do. In addition to military tankers, commercial aircraft are being utilized in the ongoing geoengineering operations, though commercial carrier personnel do not appear to be in any way involved. Why aren't the climate scientists, like those in the National Weather Service and the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administrations, speaking out? In addition to having no First Amendment protection, there is now an illegal federal gag order on all National Weather Service and all NOAA employees. Climate engineering programs are nothing short of weather warfare on innocent...
Now it's sixes and sevens, man, we never learn our lessons, and we never gave our blessings to mess around with our clouds. Now we're endowed with this shroud that is poisoned in the ground. I'm getting loud, cause we need to stop this betrayal, and every breath I inhale is tainted by chemtrails, causing summer skies to hail and your organs to fail. If your soul is for sale, you should be locked up in jail. You're looking pale, checking that the skies are clear, but if you watch a little longer, see those white lines appear, causing lies and fear, cause our demise is near. But if your mind stays sincere, then your cries will one day endear. Keep on looking up, keep looking up, hoping the sky is clear. Keep on looking up, but watch a little longer, see white lines appear. Keep on looking up, make sure your mind stays clear as the time draws near. Keep on looking up, the only power they hold over you is fear. Where's the love? It's raining poison from above, getting into everything from the water down to the shrubs. I've had enough. Now you expect me to be patient. You say you have no clue, but it's hidden inside your patents. Effects are latent, so we must just wait and see. Man, if you want a disaster, that's the perfect recipe. Now it's clear to me that something is fucking wrong, cause what they're doing up there is short of dropping a bomb. How I long for a world free of all of the tyranny, all the villainy, man, it is fucking killing me. It's no conspiracy, the truth's up in the sky. And would you put it past your governments to tell a lie? Neither would I. Let's end this hell. I'm trying to raise the issue, but you can do it as well. Cause this is World War III and I'm just ringing a bell. And the only way we'll stop them is if we stand and rebel. Keep on looking up, keep looking up, hoping the sky is clear.
We are seeing is man-made, but man-made in a different way than you may guess. Weather modification programs, experimental ones done by private companies, done by the United States government, done by states across the United States, are underway. There's more than 50 of them in operation across the United States. All of these impact agriculture because they change the microclimates needed for agriculture to survive. None of these programs that I know of today, and this is all public record, are available at any time with oversight, agricultural oversight or public oversight. These programs impact agriculture, and there are programs around the world. International corporations are modifying our weather all the time, and they're modifying it in ways that cover thousands and thousands of square miles. Most of it is chemically altered, so that what happens is that we are putting chemicals, ground-based chemicals that are shot into the air, or chemicals coming from airplanes that change and modify our weather. So one of the things that I'm concerned about and that we need to address in the future is how these programs are impacting microclimates needed for our crops to survive and needed for pollination. If we change the growing season, the pollinators may not survive, and also our crops, our flowers, and our tree crops may not get the pollination needed. So one of my areas is looking at this situation to see if we can begin to put under control experimental and other types of weather modification programs. The other issue is that a lot of times we're talking about mitigation for climate change. It's rather an undefined term at this period of time. And so what happens is that many times we're talking about artificially putting chemicals like sulfur or particulates into the atmosphere in what they call geoengineering schemes to reduce and help the planet, supposedly, but help the planet to not go through such a tremendous global climate change and to mitigate global warming. However, the incidence of putting chemicals into our atmosphere is going to change and impact agricultural crop production. And if you take and you put up into our skies chemicals to reduce the amount of sunlight reaching the earth, you are going to begin to reduce crop production. Studies at the University of Illinois on corn crop production show reductions. Without the process of photosynthesis, whereby plants from direct sunlight gain the energy to grow, to produce crops, we are going to find ourselves, if we mitigate in that direction, impacting the crop production not only here in the United States, but worldwide. One of the things that is impacting crop production right now in the United States and reducing photosynthesis and also impacting the ability of solar power panels to generate the type of power that they should is persistent jet contrails. NASA talks about persistent jet contrails as exacerbating global warming because they trap warmth in the atmosphere when they produce cirrus and man-made clouds. NASA also talks about that these aircraft leaving persistent contrails are changing our climate. And when they change our climate to the degree that one jet can leave a persistent jet contrail, which will spread across our skies, from what this picture up here on my left on the screen looks like, which is a trail left by a jet, that trail can expand to 4,000 kilometers and last for 20 hours. This was unheard of in the early 60s and the 70s, and it wasn't until the late 1980s that there was a change and we started to have persistent jet contrails that persist. NASA studies show that part of our global warming problem could be attributed to these types of contrails and the jets that leave them. So one of the issues as we go through is, how do you like your skies, natural or man-made?
This is what we have. Again, global geoengineering, the ever-changing experiment, and we are again part of that experiment. Russian scholar warns of secret U.S. climate change weapon. We have Russia engaged in this as well. We also have China, and this is one of the reasons why it's so hard to get any sort of mainstream coverage, because the big players are all involved up to their eyeballs. So that's one of the reasons the media coverage is so sparse, but it's coming. What do weather weapons do? They wreak havoc in countries without anybody knowing they're even under assault. In the case of floods, droughts, all of this is a form of weather weaponry and weather warfare. And there is no arguing that we are all a part of weather warfare when our climate is being impacted the way it is right now. Again, countries around the globe, this sort of impact, nobody would recognize as being an assault. And that's what's so prized about weather warfare for the powers that be. Nobody even knows they're being attacked. Bridges, infrastructure, wiped out. You can literally bring a country to its knees. You can bring a state to its knees as well, especially a state that doesn't seem to want to conform too much with the federal government. You can drought them out completely. And that's exactly what's happening in California right now. This sort of drought in Africa has been used for decades. We know these programs have been going on, and Their impact in Africa appears to be directly related to bringing countries to their knees and opening up the door for U.S. occupation. You have U.S. boots on the ground in about 156 countries around the globe. Not singling out the U.S. because other countries, again, as I said, are at this as well. Empty reservoirs. This is where California is headed today. I think we all know that. If we reach the end of this year without significant rainfall, we will be in free fall into a cataclysm that's never before been recorded. Our forests are going up in flames. As geoengineering impacts the system from top to bottom, it starts to feed itself. As you cut off the moisture for boreal forests, which are the lungs of the planet, the terrestrial lungs of the planet, and they begin to burn, that feeds into the entire climate cycle and begins to tilt it even further off scale. So this is a non-linear equation. Once it starts to tilt, it tilts faster and faster. These sorts of clouds historically have not been well recorded. Now they are. This sort of sky that many have become accustomed to and think is somehow normal is anything but. This is an aerosol coverage that all of you seem to have seen before. And many people have begun to accept this as being natural, but it takes a lot of material to block the sun to that degree, and all that material is settling down on all of us. We're all breathing it in. Anybody who thinks that's commercial traffic is in a...